Bonus episode, Mr. Sanchez.
Is it a bonus episode, or are we going to name it something else?
Well, we're going to name it what it's supposed to be named, and we're not going to do all the dumb things that we've been doing it, like calling episodes 14.5, because that kind of screws it up on Apple Podcasts. On Spotify, it looks fine. I'm not sure what it looks like on Stitcher or Podcaster, but on Apple Podcasts, you go to episode 14.5, and it's actually episode 15. So this is just a bonus episode. We're going to call it a bonus episode because we want to get caught up with a couple of current events and the jank line because of goddamn Rachel. And also, so this technically will be episode 22. Okay.
But we're calling it the bonus episode.
So yeah, so it's bonus episode, but it's actually bonus episode number 22. And then,
it's bone with B-O-N-E, right? Bone-is. Episode, bone us episode, right? Huh?
You gonna stick
you
with that?
What I'm
you
throwing
gonna,
down?
You gonna stick with that?
Bonus episode, get it?
I could write 22. That. I do. Hey, you're part of the team. If you want me to write that, I will. Okay.
I'm the creative writing team. Let's do it.
Okay.
Let's name it the bone us episode.
Okay. It's gonna be the B-O-N-E-us episode. Dave made me name it this. that's what I'm gonna name it.
Okay,
all right, that's what we're gonna name it. So yeah. So we had some extra content this week and we had some extra time, so you know, why not, right? Dave was down.
Sure.
And Beer Mug said he was down, but I guess not. We recorded,
he love you.
Yeah, exactly. He doesn't love you like we love you. And
yes,
we recorded our proper episode yesterday, and that'll be out on Monday like we do. And that one you guys got to listen to because we had listener Rachel on talking about the best movie ever.
No. Not the best movie ever.
We talk about a
one of the worst. It hurt my ears. So
yeah, it's and I put Dave, I ended up putting a little disclaimer at the beginning of the episode because
Thank God. So
if you guys are listening to this between 45-minute mark and an hour and 1 minute mark, if you guys aren't into super sadistic, crazy, twisted,
don't give it away.
I'm not going to give it away. Yeah. Just if you can handle that sort of stuff, then don't tune in for those 16 minutes because they get crazy. And Dave, when you think it's crazy enough and that's it, it gets crazier, right?
Two things got crazy: the story and your guys's, you and listener Rachel, speaking of the devil, your just reactions to it. And it was insane.
Yeah, I think we're cut from a similar cloth, you know. We're able to kind of like I said, listen to the episode, we kind of break it down, all that. But Dave, we wanted to do this because you were really invested in the inauguration and all that went on, and I'm the polar opposite.
Yeah.
Because I couldn't turn away fast enough, you know. I was just like, I really didn't care about J-Lo, and the only thing that I did care about happened afterwards, that because all the Bernie Sanders. So I was like, you couldn't ignore the Bernie Sanders memes, right?
Yeah, that's okay. Well, first of all, let's see, J-Lo was okay, like, all right, whatever. Lady Gaga looked like she was ready to announce the Hunger Games, which people were writing online, and that was very funny. And you know, it was cool to see the inaugurations. I watched pretty much all of them, no matter who they are, you know, because
I like to see
the speeches. But this one felt a little different, and you know, and I realized you guys were at work at the time because it was really early in the morning. Like, it started at 7 o'clock our time.
Right.
And by the time he was inaugurated, it was like 9 a.m. But there's two things that stood out was a poet from Los Angeles, Amanda Gorman, who was insane. Like, her poem was so amazing, dude. And I know you're the poetry guy.
I
so
am?
You should review it. No, not at all.
I was just gonna say, like, what? All right.
No, but you know it, like, and everyone, like, no one, if you said you know this person, you're such a liar, because who follows poetry, right?
No, like, no, exactly. All I know, well,
obviously someone
then
does, because they asked her to speak, right?
Right.
So, or do a poem.
I heard something, Dave, and tell me if I'm not mistaken, that she's 24 years old and she already has two.
22.
22.
Yeah.
And she already has two bestsellers, like books.
Hell if I know, dude.
Okay.
Like I said,
okay.
I don't know anything about her.
Okay.
All I know is that she's from Los Angeles.
Okay.
And her poem was amazing. But then you're right. The best thing to come out of it was the Bernie Sanders memes. And man, I couldn't get enough of them. I think we're recording this episode just so we could talk about it. Like, you know, everybody started doing memes, and I did one for myself, and a listener did one for us in the Janky Town. Yeah, it's just Bernie sitting there with his hands crossed, looking all curmudgeon-y and old and just not wanting to be there. And people were placing them everywhere. It is so funny. Yeah. They have them in so many different situations. And, you know, by the time people are hearing this, it should be over. I hope it's over, because 2 days of solid Bernie content was enough.
It was burning white hot. It was everywhere. I mean, you got
everybody was doing it.
Rancid was doing it. Who else did I see? Beer Mug did one, you know, with him on a subway in New York. Who else? I'm sure.
Dude, Zach Braff did one with him in Garden State. So it was Bernie in between Natalie Portman and himself.
Oh, my God.
And, you know, but they're so, like, they're so creative. And my favorite one now is the one where he's giving someone a figure, an arm bar, inside the referee. And Joe Rogan and he's like, whoa! So it's crazy. But everybody was in it, and every single one of them made me laugh.
Yeah.
So this is probably the best thing to hit the internet since, like, either the dog noses on the filters or the rainbow vomit.
Or chocolate rain.
Oh, this is way after. Like, the filter's way after chocolate rain. But yeah, but or Psy. Like,
oh, there
Gangnam
you go.
Style.
That's
so,
right, dude. That's funny,
so,
man.
Yeah. But so you didn't watch it at all. Will you go back? Like, you hear about how awesome this poem was, will you even just go check it out?
You know, on Stryker and Clyde, on Stryker and Klein, we played a clip of it, and it was just not my thing. I don't know. I you know me, Dave. I'm not a deep guy. That stuff kind of gets lost on me.
Listen, be like Kevin and do an opposite day, right? So, like, you, like, get into it. Get,
okay.
You'll beat Nikki and be like, yeah, bro.
Can I just do an opposite, like, thing? Just with this one thing? So I don't have to do an entire day and be miserable the entire day?
Hey, okay. 100%.
You know what? I'll pull it up on YouTube and play it, and I'll just give you my thoughts right now. What do you think about that?
Well, isn't it, like, 7 minutes? So
well, let's see how soon it takes me to get sick of it, then. Let's go on the YouTubes here.
We're on YouTube too. So
oh, that's right.
If you want, you know, follow us. It's Janky Town.
Amanda, what was her last name? Gorad?
Amanda Gorman.
Gorman. All right, there she is.
I was going to tweet this and I decided not to because I don't know how people would react to it. Uh-huh. But it was Amanda, whoa, more like Amanda, whoa, man, right? Huh?
I'm glad he didn't.
Ah, damn it, you should have tweeted it.
Oh, man. All right, the YouTubes is loading. I don't want to play the ad. So, okay, here we go.
Dr. Biden, Madam Vice President.
So far, I'm out.
Mr. Emhoff. Americans and the world.
Okay.
When day comes, we ask ourselves, where can we find light in this never-ending shade? The loss we carry, a sea we must wade. We've braved the belly of the beast.
Okay, first thing that I want to point out is this lady, who is 22 years old. You're telling me she's 22? She has more confidence than I ever will in my entire lifetime. Her charisma is amazing. It is on point. This is my first time watching the video. It's very stunning to watch her. And I'm just 27 seconds in. Okay, let's continue.
Right. We've learned that quiet isn't always peace. In the norms and notions of what just is, isn't always just is. And yet the dawn is ours before we knew it. Somehow we do it. Somehow we've weathered and witnessed a nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished. We, the successors of a country and a time where a skinny black girl descended from slaves and raised by a single mother, can dream of becoming president only to find herself reciting.
Where's the poem? Is that the poem?
This is the whole thing is a poem, yes.
Oh, where's the rhyming? She's just talking.
Rhyming, man.
Where's the rhyming, Dave?
It's not.
It's like, hey, man, you know,
roses are red, violets are blue. I got a jizz. How about you?
Thank you. My poem. Thank you, Dave. I like your poem a little better because it rhymes. There's no music behind it. There's nothing going on. There's no band playing. What kind of poetry is this?
Play behind poems?
I don't know.
I don't know what type of poetry is it, man, but everyone was saying this is the poem.
Okay,
right?
I'm going to fast forward.
It's called The Hill We Climb.
Okay, yeah, I'm going to fast forward to 3 minutes. Okay, here we go.
Then share
it. Yeah, we don't have time for that.
Would destroy our country if it meant delaying democracy. And this effort very nearly succeeded. But while democracy can be periodically delayed, it can never be permanently defeated. In this truth, in this faith we trust, for while we have our eyes on the future, history has its eyes on us. This is the era of just redemption. We feared it at its inception. We did not feel prepared.
Yeah, she kind of screwed up that word.
To be the heirs of such a terrifying hour, but within it we found the power to author a new chapter, to offer hope and laughter to ourselves. So, what?
Okay. I could definitively say that that is not for me. I'm closing out of that window because I'm done with it.
But like you said, though, she was just composed, and the way she's moving her hands and like just speaking eloquently, except for that little stutter.
Right.
But it's like, dude, at 22, I would have pissed my pants, man.
At 22, I was like drinking behind a Denny's, you know, and, you know, smoking cigarettes and coffee, just doing nothing with my life, you know?
Well, and look, none of us have really watch poetry or do any of that, but to me, this is the best poetry I've seen since my man Zach doing Hacky Sack, Hacky Sack, Don't Let It Fall on She's All That, man.
Okay,
bravo, or brava, as people were saying. I don't know, I didn't get that either. Brava,
that's
brava,
funny, dude. Woo. I heard something about Tom Hanks doing something. What do you know about the Tom Hanks thing?
Oh, that was a inauguration special, since they did it all televised, where they had some bands play. And,
oh, so that
and
wasn't at the White House?
Stuff like that. It was in like the Lincoln Memorial.
Oh, okay.
Mainly.
Okay.
Yeah, and so they had a bunch of people speak. And to me, honestly, the best part about that show was just hearing people's stories from around the country, you know, like nurses and little kids who were doing it. Talk about like great news. It was all, it was like an hour and a half great news special with musicians. And, you know, Foo Fighters play Time Like These Again with their little slowdown acoustic version, and they rock. Bruce Springsteen played. Katy Perry ended it with fireworks, and they fucking literally blew up the sky. It was crazy.
Oh, wow.
And Joe Biden spoke, and yeah, it was pretty cool. I fast forward through mainly all the performances, even Foo Fighters. But
can I ask you a question that you might not want to answer? The question to me is that, once President Trump left office and Joe Biden got sworn in, did you feel, my wife is all about this, by the way. She's nonstop in the last couple of days, just watching all the coverage, loves Joe Biden, can't get enough of Kamala Harris. Did you get a feeling of hope and change? I know a lot of people did.
Me personally, I have a feeling, I hope for hope. You know what I mean? I hope the person can walk the walk. You know what I mean? Like, even if it's a little bit, then I'll be happy.
Yeah.
You know, because, you know, everything was so divisive.
Ugh.
and it was getting crazy. And look, it still may get crazy, you know?
Yeah.
You know, just the coverage and all that's going to be different. But I hope for hope, you know?
Right.
I hope he can do something, even if it's a little bit. A little bit will go a long way for me.
Yeah. Do you think there's something wrong with me really not caring who the president is? And I really do feel my job as a father and head of household, my job is to kind of adjust to what the situation is, because I have so much on my plate that the last thing I want to worry about, because I have so many things going on, is politics. I am more of the thought of what's going to happen is going to happen, and I need to adjust myself to the current situation and take care of business. Am I wrong in that? Because my wife thinks that I need to be kind of invested on what's happening as an adult, and I don't know. That's just not how I tick.
Yeah, I don't think you're wrong, because I think that's the majority of people, right? Yeah. Like, you know, everybody is the outspoken people, left and right, are like, it's very minimal. We just see them because
they're on the news. Yeah, no,
yeah,
for
they're
sure.
loud and out there and stuff right. like that on both sides. But for you, as you know, I think like you're just worried about you're rolling with the punches, but at the same time, you should know what like if you're voting on something, like what that person represents and how it can affect your family.
Is it wrong that I let my wife just do all the heavy lifting? She does all the research. Dave, when we got the mail-in ballots, they send this book, and it's pretty thick ass book.
I went through it.
All that, and so it's okay for me to go, yeah, you know, you're smarter than I am when it comes down to that sort of stuff, tell me how to vote, right? That's
Look,
fine
I,
right
I,
or am I a giant jackass?
Well, listen, you know, you just got to know, because what if there's one day they're going to be like, all right, for men, we're going to start chopping off your dicks, and you're going to be like, okay, go for it. And she's going to be like, yeah, we had enough kids. Let's vote yes on that. Boom. No, but you guys are in a partnership. So, you know, I'm sure you're okay with however she speaks for your household. And, you know, so if that's how you want to run it, that's how you run it. You know, I think it gets a little skewed when you start getting a group and start forcing your way along and stuff
totally,
like that.
Totally.
So, you know, that's that.
Cool,
so,
man. Well,
we're done though for forever. No more politics.
Fingers crossed, right?
Yeah.
At least hopefully, the politics will get nice and boring again. So it doesn't, you know, get salacious where, you know, all the CNNs and Fox Newses of the world, that's all they're covering nonstop is the president, you know, it's just, and like this year or, you know, the last couple of years, more than ever, you would see politics on just the regular local TV and less of, hey, here's the man on the street covering how hot it is during the summer or how windy it is. You still get some of that, but not as much.
Yeah, I'm missing all the viral videos of, you see that leprechaun in the tree?
Me too, man. Yeah. Where, like, the reporters were
the
out there to
want.
Get, like, the crappy news.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah, like our girl Andrea Isom in Detroit.
Yes!
Like, oh, is there a monster in the river? Like, no, there isn't. It's a freaking log, but sure, go cover it. Like,
I love that sort of stuff. I missed that so far.
Man, I want the news to get back to being fun again. Yeah. Car chases and all.
Yeah.
So, we're good. Yay.
Yeah. Did you want to play this, Bernie audio from Seth Meyers? I pulled it because you sent it on the WhatsApp. Do you want to play it?
It's just him explaining. Sure, let's play it since we pulled it.
Okay,
since he did the work.
All right, this is him. Kind of his response to what the meme was about or something.
Yeah,
or?
Him seeing the meme and what's his thoughts on it.
Okay, here we go.
Were you aware that this photo was immediately sort of became the meme of the day?
Not at all. I was just sitting there trying to keep warm, trying to pay attention to what was going on.
Okay, Grandpa. He's such a grandpa,
another meme that came out of it was his to-do list. And I love that it's like he had one thing, is 1, 2, 3's to-do list. And the middle one was go to Joe's thing. And then, the third one was like
Joe's
dinner. Yeah.
That's hilarious. Oh, that's funny.
So, yeah, but I'm glad it's over now. Like, all the memes are over, hopefully.
I agree. But definitely.
And all this madness is over, hopefully.
Yeah. That definitely was fun, though, the whole meme thing. All right, let's get into it.
Janky town, Jack. Hit the ground, Jack. We can get the janky popping, that's a sound. Jack. We make your frown, Jack. Go upside down, Jack. It's getting janky, we the greatest pound for pound. What up, Mugs? Jack. What up, Dave? Jack. What up, O? Jack. What up, Janks? What up, Mugs? Jack. What up, Dave? Jack. What up, O? Jack. What up, Janks? It's getting janky. It's getting janky. It's getting janky. I love it when we jank around. It's getting janky. It's getting janky. It's getting janky. I love it when we jank around.
Janky! Town.
I told you, man. I told you Muggs wasn't going to make it, Dave.
Remember when he was alive? Oh, man, we loved so much more when he was alive.
What's wrong with Muggs? Yesterday we recorded and we were like, 2 p.m., right, Muggs? He's all like, yep, we're all good. And then
we're all good to go.
At 2 p.m., Dave and I are sitting here and I'm like, Dave, let's start recording. And Dave's like, let's give him a couple more minutes. I'm like, dude, he's not going to show up. And he hits him up on the WhatsApp. Has he responded, Dave?
Not at all.
Not at all. Jesus, Muggs, what's wrong with you?
I don't know. Let's call him. Let's
keep... No, I don't want to call him.
Let's just get into that.
No, but yeah, thank you for listening to Janky Town. This is episode 22 officially. We're not going to do any more of that 0.5
no,
BS.
No, it's not. What's the episode?
This is 22.
It's a
bonus episode, but it's number 22, I guess. And yeah, if you guys want to reach out to us via the email, jankytown69@gmail.com. And you could always call the Jank line, 855-JANKY69 for that. And yeah, so this episode, we just want to get caught up on some of the Jank calls because, man, you guys are amazing. Every time you guys call the Jank line, I just get blown away. Dave, this call here, in my opinion, is so just next level, and it's just so humbling that somebody took what we did. And remember when Kevin and Bean would do something funny and somebody would take it and remix it?
Yeah.
Well, remix!
Ring! Ring, 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 ring! Ring, 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 ring! Ring, 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 ring! Ring, cling, 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 B R I N G, cling, 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 cling,
cling, cling, cling, cling, cling, cling, cling,
Who is that? Who did that?
I have no idea because they just left that and no name, no number. So I don't know. I can't give credit.
Is that a live remix or did he tape it? No, I'm just like, play it?
I think he must have. He took the audio from the podcast, put it into some sort of program, dropped fat beats, and it's even got a bass line. And here's the problem when people take some of this audio and do remixes is that it's just repetitive and it gets boring. Yeah. His started out like ring, 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 ring. Then the bass line came in, and then it's R-I-N-G. It was genius, man. He put a lot of work into that. I love that. Can we hear it one more time?
Yeah, yeah, let's do it.
That's awesome, man. I love this.
Ring, 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 ring. Ring, cling, 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 B R I N G, cling, 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 cling,
ah, so good.
How long is it?
That is about 23 seconds, something like that. 23 seconds.
Not bad.
So good, man. So good.
That should be like if we ever have hold music, that should be it.
Oh, yeah, totally.
R-I-N-G.
Yeah, we've got to work on live phone calls. And I maybe this weekend I'll have some time to kind of figure that out. This next one is for Muggs. If he was here, I'm sure he would appreciate this, but the guy's such a dick.
I'll do it.
Beer Mug is here. All right, Beer Mug here.
Hey. That's outrageous.
Am I
here? All right, here's a phone call for you, Mux. Here you go.
Am I here, Mug? I hope you get better from the corona.
We love you.
Oh, thanks, kid. Oh, man, that is so rad. Oh, wait, he doesn't say rad. That's so outrageous. What is he, snarling, or what is he doing?
No, yo, you're
saying... Johnny Chicago.
You're trying to say Shroupit? That's Fig, dude.
Shroupit, yeah.
No, that's Fig. Remember the surf guy.
Isn't he the body... Isn't, like, Beer Mug a bodyboarder now, too? So,
oh, yeah,
like,
that's
true. I'm Beer Mug.
Okay.
That's my mugs.
Oh, yeah, we don't even need Beer Mug. We have you. That's funny. All right, next call.
Hey, guys. Listener Chanel from Florida here. You asked women to call in if they think farts are funny. I think farts are goddamn hilarious. I don't know. I'm 28 years old, and I just think farts are hilarious. And I bet you all the women that listen to Janky Town think farts are hilarious. So where my ladies at? All right. You also asked for fart stories, so here you go.
Oh, nice.
I was once trying to court a man, and he may have been giving me a massage, and I may have been naked. And and I was half asleep, kind of falling asleep. The massage was so nice. And so I reached back to, kind of pat him on the leg and say, like, oh, thank you. This is so nice. And I was patting something and I said, that's your leg, right? And he goes, nope, that's my penis. I reached my arm back and said, oh, in surprise. And because I was half asleep. And when I reached my arm back in surprise, I said, oh, he farted. bare ass right on him. We've been married 5 years. Thank you.
Yes! Oh, no way! That's great! Oh, my God.
That's
God. Yeah, dude. Yeah. Oh, she must be smoking hot, dude. Right? If a girl farts on you. Is this the parrot lady?
This is a parrot lady.
Oh, no way. Oh, wow. That's amazing, dude. That's great.
That's awesome.
Oh, my God.
Dude, first she touches penis.
Is that your penis?
Thought it was his leg.
That's whoa, penis, that's a big dong. Yeah, that's a big dong, right?
So good for her.
Yeah.
And then she farted. Oh, man. Dude. Oh, have you ever had a massage? I don't take you as a massage guy because have you ever been that relaxed where you're just like, whoops?
No, the only person that's ever attempted to give me a massage is the wife. And even when the wife gives tries to give me a massage, I'm not really into it. It's just hard for me to receive pleasure, I guess, in that sense. I'm telling you, Dave, I'm just not that guy. I'm not that guy. Even if I had money and I would spend money on it, I don't think I would enjoy it. Just somebody strange, their hands all over me, trying to relax me. I'm not about it. You know what I do enjoy is just going in the hot tub. I relax that way, have a beer, pop it open. I find that relaxing. Some stranger with oils and stuff, that sounds disgusting to me for some reason.
Oh, you're missing out so much, man.
Hey, let me ask you this, Dave. You're a massage guy. You've gotten, would say, 100 maybe in your lifetime? Or 50?
No. Maybe a couple, like 20 to 30.
Has there ever been a time where your masseuse was very attractive and you ended up getting a boner action?
You know what? Oh, no.
Don't.
Because I've had attractive masseuses,
yeah.
But your face is in this little circular thing, so you're just putting down and the way they're massaging you, it depends on what kind you get to. Even when they get on the inner thigh, sometimes they're squeezing hard and stuff like that. So it's more of a oh, that feels good for the muscles and stuff like that. Because I usually get Swedish massages, which are the tickly massages.
Okay.
Oh,
that sounds like hell. They tickle you?
Oh, it's so good. Dude.
Really? Wow.
Yeah, it's just an hour of that.
Wow.
But no erections, but I've fallen asleep and maybe tooted one or two times, you know. Yeah. But not in someone's face. They're just working on your neck and you're like, whoops, ooh, damn.
I remember
never while they were in that area.
When I first started on Kevin and Bean, there was a report on the news, I believe, that if you get a colonic, and I was overweight. You remember, dude, I was super chubby guy, right? And the news report said that if you get a colonic, you could drop 10 pounds because you have 10 pounds of just icky gook inside your intestine, right? So Kevin and me were I think they asked you first to get the colonic.
They
and you're like, nope,
they
exit
did.
Only.
I said, nope. I was like, I can't stick a tube in my butt.
Yeah, and I was like I'll do it.
I was like, You stepped up.
And
by the way, this is when you were still behind the scenes.
Oh,
not
yeah.
even thought of
absolutely.
Let's put them on air.
Yep.
It's and you're like, I'll do it.
Yeah,
like,
absolutely.
Let's go.
And I go and the lady is this she's this black lady. And I she didn't call her lady. She, this girl, she was smoking hot. She was in her mid 20s. And just I'm like, oh my God, no, I'm going to let, because I was, when I was picturing a colonic, I was picturing, somebody in their 50s, they're going to stick, something in my butthole in a doctor's office. I wasn't picturing, it's a regular house, but as soon as you walk in, you feel like it's in a spa. So it was like one of those kind of deals. And I was like, oh my God, no, this lady's attractive. I think, what if I do get a boner? But no, as soon as you stuck that in my hose, there's no
all
sexiness.
Dead.
It's like, yeah.
So they flood your butthole with water?
Yeah, dude. It's so weird because you feel your intestine or your stomach. I'm not sure what part of it, but you feel yourself filling up with water, and then she releases it, and then, dude, stuff comes out. And there's a clear hose where you could see the stuff coming out. And Kevin, you know how squeamish Kevin is. He went with me to record the bit. He almost threw up because he had a line of sight to my beehole and the water line, the clear water line, dude.
Dude, we've seen so much of each other.
Yeah,
too much
I know.
Of,
yeah,
of
too
of
much.
Each other. I remember, so when you pulled out the tube, did you sniff it?
No. No.
just to check,
no.
Am I clean now?
No, man, no.
Oh, dude, but that reminds me of talking about massages and your butts and stuff like that. I had a mud massage in Tulum. Chris and I, my girlfriend, had a this couple's mud massage, and the lady who was putting mud all over me, she ended up putting her thumb on my butthole, right? And then massaging mud all around it. She didn't stick her finger in it.
No, yeah, yeah, yeah.
But she like covered it because she didn't want mud to go in it. So I was like, oh, hi.
Like, did you not say anything? Like, no butthole action? No?
No.
You're all like, is that normal? No.
Well,
did she give you, did you sign a waiver? Like, hey, yeah, you can touch my butthole. Like, that doesn't seem proper, Dave.
Oh, it was in Mexico? Yeah, Tulum. This is in Tulum.
Okay.
So, but we're doing like this mud, you know, like
I didn't know in Mexico, by the way, the buttholes were a free-for-all, but, you know.
Neither did I. But like I said, it was just like if I'm putting on the video, like you could just, it was pressed. It wasn't like stuck in.
Yeah, no, right? Yeah. Wow.
So she, you know, the massage happens and all that. And you know, I got a girl and Krista got a guy. And,
yeah.
And then we wash off and we're showering. And I was like, hey, did he cover your butthole with his thumb? And she's like, what? And I was like, no, okay, just me, I guess. I was like, okay. Man. I was like, what? Did my butthole, was it so big that she had to cover it? Or
man,
she
didn't want mud? No, dude, no.
And I was like, what's wrong with the little natural mud going in with human mud?
You so, oh, just, gross. You just had a very, very nice butthole. I would imagine that it wasn't like, it didn't put her off, you know? So
yeah, maybe,
she felt comfortable
maybe
putting her thumb on your butthole.
Her thumb in there. Oh, yeah, so that was the only time I've had a thumb in my butthole.
That's
on
crazy.
My butthole,
love
not
it.
In it. So, yeah.
All right.
Oh, man, that message is way better. What's up, guys? This is Alex from San Francisco. You can reach me at
626. Oh, okay. Yeah, we'll skip that call because I want to do a proper episode. That's Alex from San Francisco, and he is the guy that called a couple of episodes ago and did all those animal noises. So he is volunteering.
Oh.
Yeah, so he left it. Remember, he didn't leave his number, so he's leaving his number there so we could do a Wheel of Animal Voices with him. So, yeah, so that's coming soon.
So the new Wheel of Animal Voices is we're going to just put animals, and he's going to have to do the imitations of them.
Let's try it, man. Let's see what happens. Yeah, for sure, man. I mean, he was really good at it, but it was very funny.
They were, man.
It was very funny.
They were pretty good.
Yeah, so we'll try that out in a future episode.
What's up, guys? Anthony from Montebello. I know I hear the Janksters and the Jankalinos and Jankafarians, but fuck that. This is the insane clown Jankies. The fucking Jankalos. What the fuck? What? Jankalos in the house.
The Jankalos, I think, is going to be like we have to come up with like a drink, like a Janky Town drink, because what are the Juggalos drink? They drink
a Faygo.
Faygo, yeah, Faygo. So what's going to be our drink of choice? Faygo.
Well, listen, we all
are we Four Loko?
Thanks.
Are we Four Loko?
Oh, no, because I don't want to drink that. We're going to have to drink it if we're calling it the Janky drink.
Okay. If we have some Jankalos, though, out there and have any suggestions for what our drink is going to be, like the Juggalos have the Faygo, yeah, please let us know.
You know, our drink's going to be like a fucking pussy drink with like chocolate milk and like vodka and like, you know, whipped cream on it and a cherry or something.
Whoa, what just happened, Dave?
My mic just fell.
Oh, my God. You know, it was for me, I'm watching you. So it was like, are you in an earthquake? Because it knocked down your camera a little. I was like, oh, crap. What's happening over there?
Nope. I just dropped my mic.
Okay. Yeah. But suggestions, please, on the new drink of choice for the Jankalos. Yeah, I think that's funny. All right.
Oh, Omar, you motherfucker, dude. I'm listening to the episode where Beer Mug gets coronavirus, and I hear all these phone calls about people having to sit through a 2-minute fucking intro, and I call wanting to complain about that, and all of a sudden I hear, Jake Line, I just changed the message. You asshole. Anyways, I love the work that you and Beer Mug do. Fuck Dave.
And Dave.
Dave sucks.
Aww.
Anyways, squish.
Dave, how many episodes, by the way, you're welcome, sir, for changing the voicemail there, the outgoing message. Dave, how many episodes do you think Muggs has missed?
Off the top of my head, I'm going to say 3 or 4.
Yeah, I think more like on the four side. And
yeah.
I don't know what's up with Muggs. I can understand the Corona episode once. But like today, for instance, no, sorry, I can't make it, guys. Nothing.
No.
Just he just ditched us. So, yeah, so that's Muggs.
Yeah, so yeah, if you're listening to this episode today, why don't you send him a social media message, because he loves us. And especially on Twitter or Instagram, at Johnny Beer Mug, I guess. And just let him know, hey, where were you, dick?
Yes.
That's it. And he'll know.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Hi, my name is Lisa. I am a 30-year listener of The Kevin Bean Show and an original listener of the podcast. And inspiration hit me today. I was listening to, I think it was 14.5, and I don't know if it's the way, Omar, you said it, but you said Corona, talking about Beer Mug, and it totally made me think that you guys, especially, I think Beer Mug would be awesome if he sings a song called My Corona, you know, kind of instead of My Sharona. I think you guys should make that and get that done. I know when Beer Mug recovers from the Corona, I think that's something that'd be great. Thank you. I hope you like my idea. My name is Lisa.
Yeah, we totally liked that idea, but it was like one of the first parodies that was done when coronavirus started becoming a thing. Remember when that was a thing, Dave, where people were just taking it super lighthearted and thought, ah, it's funny, people are getting sick, but it wasn't like this still whole, like, worldwide people are dying thing, and it was just like, ah, oh, let's have fun with Corona. But yeah, there's already a parody like that out there.
Yeah, it's, I see one by Z Dog MD. This is My Corona.
Okay.
Yeah, and then there's another one by Stephanie Foreman and another one by Paul Benson.
Yeah,
but you know what? The one I loved was the Cardi B remix. Coronavirus, coronavirus, that shit is real. Or that other dude's song.
That was good.
Yeah,
that
remember
good.
That?
Yeah, that was good. That
and
was
then
good.
And then that other dude, some unknown rapper, well, he has a name, but I don't know. Maybe I could look it up real quick. But it was a, move, bitch, you got coronavirus.
Oh, really?
Don't sneeze on me. You got coronavirus. It was dope, dude. It was actually a really good song. I wish
that's
I had remembered.
Funny. It, but, yeah, but that My Sharona parody has been done. But yeah, you can find it on the YouTubes. All right, next.
Yeah. Oh, much better message, guys. Hey, this is Scott from Phoenix, multiple-time caller. Listen to every episode and the B-Team
Thanks,
episode.
Scott.
Yes, Dave, I've listened to all of them.
Liar.
And from that, I just want to say, Omar, you're doing a great job. We know that you do 97%
Thanks.
Of the work. You're getting much better, and I can hear the improvement at every episode. I know you guys don't like compliments, but I wanted to give that to you, Omar. Dave, God, I just wish you did more. I feel like you've got so much to contribute.
Come on.
I just wish you did more. And Beer Mug.
97.
Well, times are tough for you right now, Beer Mug. So keep your chin up, and when you're ready, you can bring the fire to the Janky Town podcast. Squish.
Squish, man, that dude is super nice, and I appreciate
you. Well, thanks, Steve, man. Like, I could do more, but you know what? I'm really busy with not dying and trying to breathe and stuff, and I got to do things with myself. Yeah. Outrageous.
It's so funny because, yeah, he's recovered from the coronavirus. He's ready to bring the fire, yet he's not here. So that's classic Mugs,
though. Remember when he was supposed to write a song for us?
That never happened. Yeah, he was supposed to do,
Don't say what kind of song.
He
was tasked one thing, and
by the way,
yeah.
He reminds me a little of like a Big Mama James Scorch, because this is kind of classic Mugs, and he always gets a pass because that's Mugs, you know.
That's what I do.
I wish I was that guy. Can I always get a pass just for, you know, not showing up to work and not showing up to do a podcast and, you know, having people depend on me and wanting to hear me on a show, but I just decide I'm not gonna do it and I'm not gonna give anybody a heads up and people being cool with it? How is that possible, Dave? Like, how does that work? But it does work for Mugs.
Because, listen, it's like those people, I call them puppies.
Okay.
Because you reprimand them. No, bad puppy. You hit them on the nose. And then they look at you with their big old eyeballs. And he's like, yeah, I'm sorry, man. And you're like, ah, oh, fuck, Mugs. All right. You know, you're a cool guy.
Yeah.
You know, don't do it again. All right, well, outrageous.
He is. He's very lovable.
That's not brown rice.
Oh, man.
Hey, guys. Come here. Did you know in the song Old Town Road, he says, I'm going to take my horse to the Old Town Road?
Yeah, of course.
I thought he said, I'm going to take my horse to the hotel room.
What?
Ooh.
Fucking song sucks so much.
Wait, now it sucks that it wasn't. I'm gonna take my horse to the hotel room.
I guess so. Maybe he wanted. He wanted like a song about bestiality or something.
I don't know. sir, you may enjoy the movie that Omar reviews in the next episode.
Yeah. That's Hot Sauce Tim, by the way. Great delivery, by the way.
Oh, I love that. Nice. What up, yeah. Tim?
All right, next.
Yo, this is Steven from Ontario, California, guys. And real quick, Omar, I have a quick question for you. So, how do you pronounce Gal Gadda? Gadda? Gadda?
So he's referring to when Allie is not on Stryker and Klein, I pick up the slack and I do what they call the ADD news report. Basically, it's a showbiz news report. And there was Gal Gadot. I still don't know how to say her name. Is it Gal Gadot or Gal Gadot? It's one of those two.
Listen. Before, we had this discussion with Ralph when he was doing the Showbiz Beat. And I believe the correct Israeli pronunciation. And if you were an Israeli, you could totally correct this.
Okay.
But it's Gal Gadot, right?
Gal Gadot.
It's Gal Gadot.
Okay. Okay. Gal Gadot. Well, I had a giant brain fart on the air.
Well, hold on.
Okay.
But I think even she has given up because in this new Netflix promo video for this year that's recent. It was out like 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
She goes, "Hi, I'm Gal Gadot." You know, I think she just gave up and says, "Just say my name, however you want."
Okay.
You know, I'm Gal Gadot. So it's Gal Gadot, not Gal Gadot.
But yeah, so I had problems pronouncing her name, and Stryker and Klein wouldn't just let it go. They wouldn't let it go. So they were like making fun of me for like 30 seconds, and I couldn't get it right. But yeah, good times.
Does that sound like somebody, huh? Mr. Pandemic.
Hey, but it's fine. You know, make fun of me as long as I could make fun of, you know, one eye. Okay.
Good morning, gentlemen. I would like to file a grievance.
Uh-oh.
With Dave, the supposed king of Mexico.
Why?
First of all, how are you the king of Mexico and don't like salsa? That's just...
Because Jimmy Kimmel said so.
That's just wrong. Second of all, fuck your McRibs. This whole time, Dave has been talking about it.
Wait, so who did he say? What did he say?
He said, fuck the McRibs.
Oh, okay.
Your McRibs.
Yeah.
Okay.
This whole time, Dave has been talking about it and hyping them up, and they fucking suck.
Yes, they do.
Decided to get one after 30 years of living on this earth to try it. I bite into it, and I spit it out, just like his mom does.
Damn.
So,
that's my grievance. Fuck Dave.
Okay.
You no longer deserve to be called the king of Mexico. You don't even like salsa. You probably think Tapatio is spicy.
I like how that's his one thing. Like, you're not Mexican because you don't like salsa.
That's just a shame.
Yo, forget the fact.
Anyway.
Whoa, sorry.
No, go ahead.
Okay.
Finish it.
That's just a shame. Anyway, fuck the McRib. And fuck Dave. Also, I've been hitting him up on Instagram, and he wants to justify the sandwich and compare it to a hot dog. To a hot dog. What the fuck?
I don't know.
Bye. 323.
Did he hit you up about the McRib and a hot dog?
I don't really like hot dogs. Like, that's not my go-to defense for anything.
Okay.
So I don't know what he's referring to. But he's... Why is he mad?
I don't know.
Yeah, for the three listeners who don't come from the Kevin and Bean, you know, family, the reason why I got the King of Mexico name was because Jimmy Kimmel, we were out to lunch with the guys, and I don't speak Spanish, and, you know, I don't eat salsa, I don't like spicy food, I don't like anything like that. Like traditional Mexicans would. He goes, what are you, the fucking king of Mexico or something like that? And it stuck. And there we are. Here we are. So yeah, so never mind that I don't speak Spanish or I don't like tequila and all that. But he's mad that I don't like salsa. Although paste picante is really good.
Yeah. By the way, I love that. Do you love your nickname, Dave the King of Mexico?
Do I love it? It's not bad. It's pretty cool.
I love it, especially because you have that rad story that Jimmy Kimmel gave you that nickname. Not many people have that story, especially like Jimmy's like a superstar now, you know? That's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hi, so my name is Thalia, and there's something that's been bothering me for a couple years.
Couple.
What did I do?
So, a couple years ago, Beer Mug did an interview with Michael Rooker from The Walking Dead. And I vaguely remember it was the cringiest thing I had ever heard. And I just want to rehear that interview.
Well, we don't have it. Sorry, because Beer Mug's not here. So
Hold on. We have the tape.
Oh, okay.
Hey, Michael Rooker, how are you doing? What's it like playing Merle? Damn it, boy! Get the fuck out of my face! All right, you're outrageous. That's not brown rice. There you go.
Wow. There you go. All right. Good. Good.
She heard it.
The hell.
Hey guys, this is Steven from Ontario, California. I just fucking ran away from the battle between DJ Omar Khan and Rachel on Twitter, and holy shit, I was like, whoa, this is way too much. This is going to be huge ass war. I think Geometric Banana Suit survives, and she's like, fuck this shit, I am out. All right, so put me in the middle. You guys kill each other with that battle. All right, have a good one.
Yeah, man, we were just having fun. I love Rachel, but I did get kind of a little tipsy one night. And then what did I write, Dave? I'm like, the reckoning's coming. Or
the reckoning
thing.
Is coming. Yeah,
yeah, but nah, there was nothing behind that. Actually, we have Rachel. Like I said before, we had Rachel on episode 23, and we're talking about our favorite movie, the Serbian film.
Yo, what's going on, guys? This is Alex from San Francisco. I just wanted to give a huge shout-out to Robert from Minuteman Chino, the best Yankee Town sponsor. I asked for a request to get my nephew a personalized baseball card. He's in Little League. Dude, it is freaking sick. The guy did everything and even more than I could have asked for. I mean, this is a really, really amazing little card that this guy's going to love forever, so I appreciate him. And I'll send it in the Instagram. Thanks, guys. Bye-bye.
Oh, man, that's awesome to hear, dude. Yeah, Robert at Printchino, he's the best. Like, any kind of printing need you need, he can hook you up. Definitely check him out at printchino.com. They're the best. Dave's used them, and, you know, the mugs and the T-shirts that he's done for us, they're just unbelievable, man. Yeah, definitely.
Did someone say my name?
It just said a coffee mug. Sorry, it wasn't a beer mug. It was just coffee mug.
All right.
See you, Mugs.
All right.
What up, guys? Austin from Florida here. Hope all's well. Two quick comments about the Adam Ray podcast. Love the message at the end about everyone's just got to be a little nicer, man. I know it's all fun and games with you guys, but, man, it sucks when people cross that line. So good job for getting on good word. And also, Adam Ray was really digging into Omar. Was that just for fun, or was there something more behind that? Let me know.
Dave, I will let you answer this because, man, it was a bizarre thing for me. Go ahead.
I don't know, man. What did you say about him? He was coming at you.
You were there the entire time.
He was spitting fire.
He was
spitting fire at you, man. And he was like, all right, Omar, shut up. Let me answer the question.
Listen, I never claim to be a professional broadcaster, professional interviewer, nothing like that. I know I am podcast material, right? And I get that. And I love that. So that's why when I asked him a question, I stuttered and stammered because that's my style. I'm not a pro. And man, he just relentlessly just went after me the entire show. However, it was for comedy effect. He was just being totally funny. And I truly loved it. I'm a huge Adam Ray fan, and I love when he does crowd work, and I felt like the entire episode it was just crowd work on me because he was just railing on me the entire time.
He sure singled you out.
He did.
Yeah, but Adam Ray's crowd work album is out now, and follow him on Instagram and Twitter at Adam Ray Comedy.
He's the best. And if you want to laugh your ass off, his Instagram and his Twitters and the TikToks are just the best around, man. He's so creative, and he puts out content like a couple times a day. It's crazy.
Yeah, Adam Ray was one of my favorite all-time performances at April Fool's
Show. Oh, so
the
funny
one set where he did the double dong. Oh, dude, it fucking killed me.
He's the best.
We wish you a Merry Jankmas. We wish you a Merry Jankmas. We wish you a Merry Jankmas. And we're around right next year.
Okay, love you guys. Bye.
Oh, I like that. I wish we would have heard that in December.
Hey, man, just can't get to it. It's not bad. What day today? It's January 22nd, about a month later. It's fine. We're catching up, Dave. That's why we're doing this bonus episode.
Right,
or
yes,
bonus us episode, because, yeah, we're catching up. And this is the final call for the session.
Dancing Mexico, where do you get beans? And why do you have to eat fighting food every day? And drinking Mexico, I'm pooping. And
what?
I know that it's different, but I have clouds in my ears. Drinking Mexico, bye. You got a fly on your head. This is Andrea, and I'm calling from California.
Listen, I didn't understand most of it, but that fly on your head, dude, is hilarious.
Normally, I cuss out Andrea, but I think we're becoming friends now.
Yeah, especially.
I think
she's a funny kid.
You got a fly on your head.
Are you kidding me?